Starting with the now, the new horror movie blockbuster that's just came out on August 19th, 2016 is a movie called Lights Out, directed by David F. Sandberg. It's a horror movie that revolves around a monster that only appears where there is no light. When a light is turned on, the monster disappears. This movie is based upon an independent short released on December 30th, 2013 of the same concept, also directed by David F. Sandberg. On October 31st, 2013, a story I wrote was uploaded about a monster that only shows up in the dark and disappears when the lights are on. Well, when the short came out, although I was disheartened as it was the one idea I've had that I'd love to have made into a short, as the concept is relatively simple yet effective, I was okay with it. All that was similar was the concept of the monster, something that, although heavily coincidental if you're naive, is something that does no harm. However, with this movie out, I now have more meat to compare to mine, and when side by side, it's interesting to see. But don't take my word for it, here are some side by sides of the movie and excerpts of my video. And note, the movie involves a lot of characters, whereas mine is about one, so I'm comparing the concepts and ideas, not the people exactly. Also, there's one scene in particular that really seals it for me. The first scene happens early in the movie, of a worker noticing this odd figure, and I'll play it alongside with what happens in my story. I went around the house turning off the lights. When I got to the last one in the dining room, before I would head upstairs to bed, I flicked it off and, as I turned around, I caught a glimpse of a figure. I turned the light off again. He was there, this time closer. This next part is an encounter with the monster. This time with intrigue. Wait, was I talking about the movie or the story? I don't know, it's the same bit. I stared for what seemed like a long time. In reality, it was only minutes, but to me, it felt like hours due to the tension in the air. It wasn't until I turned the light off in frustration that I made my first startling discovery. It was the lights. This next one is a small bit, an idea that the monster terrorizes at night, so it leads to a lack of sleep and tiredness the next day. The day after was my day off, so I took full advantage of this by sleeping through the whole day. I was exhausted, and who wouldn't be? This next one was a fun scene in my story. This part has the protagonist encountering the monster up close and falling in shock through the terrifying detail. My attention was then immediately taken to the other end of the kitchen. There he was, only a few feet away. He was no longer lurking outside my house, but he appeared inside. I could actually see details now. He stood there, rigid as ever. His face bore the contours of age on his skin. His clothes were no different, being measly black rags tattered around his body. In the dark, I couldn't see his eyes, but I knew they were focused purely on me. This next scene has the character feeling scared and mistrusting the rest of the house, save for the comfort of a bedroom. This completely took away my trust of all my rooms except my bedroom. This next part is about a light source failing, and just about being saved by a backup weaker source, leading to heavy tension. To keep out the cold from the kitchen to the rest of the house, I closed the door. I opened my fridge, grabbed a few cans, and just as I closed the fridge, the kitchen light bulb blew.
All this information sank in between the time it took me to panic and open the fridge door for the meat bulb to barely illuminate the kitchen.
Here's another scene in which panic is caused by lights going out. And, last second, something is done.
I turned around and scattered towards the door, reaching in a panic and almost pulling the thing off its hinges to get it open. The luminescence from the other room soon filled most of the dining room, and with it, the apparition left.
This next one is really one that clinches it in my mind. There's a part, due to lights being the only way to be saved, my guy goes around the house, hiding light sources everywhere, and huddling down. This was it, the last stand. This scene also happens in the movie.
I'm currently in my room with the lights on, and as a precaution, a dozen lamps scattered around the place, all turned on.
Here's a small part where a door is barricaded.
The door is barricaded so nothing can get in and out of here.
Now, this last one I'm pulling out for you is the ending, in which the protagonist is okay with light sources, but due to shoddy power, the monster gets them.
So, until then, all I have to do is survive.
There are large chunks of my story that I've managed to line up, and this is me trying to keep things short. I didn't include relatively similar parts or overall concepts and vibes of scenes. So many times I thought I was crazy and shouldn't make this. When it was just the short, I figured the concept was the same. When the movie came out, I asked some friends if the idea sounded similar to my idea. But when I got them to listen to my story after, their jaws dropped. And from that reaction, I looked into it the amount that I have. So many things keep coming back to the idea that I think my idea was stolen. It's a shame because in my story, there's contact with a person on a forum who has information. Where did they get that? Who were they? These were concepts I was going to expand on if I ever carried on the story, but I'm sorry to say, the release of the short did kind of kill it for me. I knew if I would have carried on using the concept, it would have been me called a plagiarist, and I didn't want that. There are even comments on the video mentioning the movie, though there are some mentioning that it predates it. If you want to be the judge for yourself and have seen the movie, I highly recommend listening to my story, 1.5 times speed if you want to rush it, and please, it would actually mean a lot. Let me know what you think, and leave a comment on here. The movie itself was predicted to make $13 million on its first week. However, smashed that target, reaching over $60 million, closer to 70. When the short came out, I always motivated myself, saying, I'm capable of coming up with brilliant ideas and concepts. I have Word documents that have over 20 pages with a lot of my ideas just listed out. But now this has made me hesitant to use them. It's a strange feeling to describe when you piece all this together, the possible implication, then see someone else make millions due to an overnight project. And as a leaving piece, during this interview, after the success of the 2013 short of Lights Out, David F. Sandberg cites creepypastas as one of his influences in the genre.